Sonoff Basics, a $5 Wi-Fi switch that can make any device smart in just a few minutes. Until now, you might be using the Sonoff Basics to control a single device only. But do you know it can control multiple devices also? How? Watch this video. Sonoff Basic. As the name suggests, it is a very basic kind of Wi-Fi switch that can control only one device. But with a little tweak, you can control up to four devices with it, and that too with minimal efforts. So let's start. This process consists of three steps. Step 1 is the flashing part, step 2 is the software part, and the step 3 is the hardware part. Looks difficult? But it's not. Let's move on to the first step, which is flashing. Sonoff has provided a flashing pin header in each of its switch that consists of 4 pins, 3.3 volts, RX, TX and ground. We can flash our Sonoff using these 4 pins. For that we need this FTDI serial adapter. Connect this adapter to your Sonoff as shown. 3.3 volt from adapter to 3.3 volt on Sonoff header. TX to RX, RX to TX and ground to ground. Now hold down the button on the Sonoff and plug the FTDI adapter to the USB port on your computer. Wait 2 seconds and then release the button. Your Sonoff has now entered the flash mode. Let's move on to the software part now. We will flash a new firmware called Tesmota into our switch. For that, go to this link and download tesmota.bin. Then go to this link and download Tesmotizer by clicking options 1, get Windows standalone executable. I'm using Windows. If you are using any other platform, download as per your requirement. All options are available on the same page. Now open Tesmotizer. If COM port is not visible, click refresh to auto detect it. If you want to backup the existing firmware in case you want to return to the original Sonoff software later, check save original firmware. It's optional. Now click open to select the already downloaded tesmota.bin file and click tesmotize. If you had selected the backup option, it will first backup the existing firmware. Once it completes, it will ask you to repeat the plug-in process. Unplug and replug the adapter while holding down the onboard button to enter the flash mode again and click OK. Once the process is finished, your Sonoff device will reboot and will create an access point named Tesmota with some alphanumeric code. Connect to that access point, open your browser and enter 192.168.4.1 and you will be presented with Tesmota main page. Enter your Wi-Fi SSID and password and hit save. At this point, your Sonoff device should connect to your router. Go to your router setting page and look for the IP address of this device assigned by your router. It will appear with name Tesmota and last 6 letters of its MAC address. Once the IP is known, enter the IP in your browser and you should be able to see the Tesmota main page again. If not, unplug and replug the device to restart it manually. Or recheck for any error in the IP address that you are entering. Once you reach the main page, click toggle to check if your device LED is responding to it. If it's responding, you have successfully flashed your Sonos device with Tasmota firmware. Now it's time to change some advanced settings. For that, again click Configuration and then Configure Module. You will see the Sonos basic module parameters. Now there could be two cases. Case 1. If you are using older version of the Sonos basic with ESP8266 chip, in that case, here is the list of GPIOs that are easy to locate on it. GPIO 0 is connected to the toggle button on the board. GPIO 1 is TX, GPIO 3 is RX, GPIO 12 is connected to the onboard relay, GPIO 13 is connected to the onboard LED, and GPIO 14 is freely available. On the given page, we can easily set the modes of GPIO 1, 2, 3, 4, and 14. Out of these 5 pins, GPIO 2 and 4 are not easily accessible. Hence, we will use the other 3 pins only. So that means we can add up to 3 more relays to this board without much efforts and almost without soldering. Although if you want to go even further and you are willing to solder a few wires, you can even control more devices. If you want to know that procedure, do write in the comments and we'll discuss that in an upcoming video. Now we will make settings for GPIO 1, 3 and 14 as shown. Set them as relays and number them starting from second because number 1 is already assigned to the onboard relay. If you do not want to add 3 relays, set the unused pins to none. Alternatively, you can also set the unused pins to act as a manual button for the relay as shown. Set the button number to be the same as relay number that you want to control. Or you can also add a DHT11 sensor to a free GPIO pin to collect temperature and humidity data and can later use that data to trigger various automations. Once you make the desired settings, hit save and the module will restart. This was the first case. Now the case 2. If you are using the newer version of the Sonos Basic with ESP8285 chip, all the GPIO pins are same except for GPIO 14. GPIO 14 is not populated in this board, but in place of it, GPIO 2 is available. So in this version of Sonos, we can use GPIO 2 instead of GPIO 14. So that means in the newer version also, we can add up to 3 more relays without much efforts. So set the pins GPIO 1, 2 and 3 as shown. Again, if you do not want to add 3 relays, set the unused pins to none or use them as button pins or a sensor as discussed earlier. In both the cases, after restart, you will be able to see additional buttons as per the selected relays and their numbers. So here, the basic software part is over. Now let's move on to the hardware part. To extend hardware, we need some DC 5 volt relay modules depending on the number of devices that you want to control. You can add a single or a double channel relay module for this purpose. Make sure to buy relay modules that have an onboard optocoupler to maintain the isolation between the two boards. Connect VCC to all relays from one end of onboard relay or the last pin of AM1117 voltage regulator as shown. We can't use 3.3 volt from Sonos header as it's too low to power 5 volt relays. Connect ground to Sonos ground. Connect data pins of relay modules to selected GPIOs. And that's it. Our hardware part is done. Power on your Sonos board and see it in action. Here's a caution. Sonos devices use mains power to operate. You must take extreme care while handling mains power devices as they can kill you. So mind it before powering it on. So everything is working as planned. Fantastic. Now let's do some optional tasks. If you want to expose all these newly created devices to Alexa to control them with voice, click Configuration, then click Configure Other. On the next screen, give this device a name. In friendly name fields, give unique names to your all devices like light, fan, bulb, lamp 1, lamp 2, etc. In emulation field, select Hue Bridge and hit save. Your device will now restart. Now go to the Alexa app, discover and set up your new devices. If you use Home Assistant and want to control through it, then you first need to configure MQTT communication. For that, click Configuration, then click Configure MQTT. Enter MQTT host IP, username and password. Enter a topic name. We are giving test lamps. Hit save to restart. In Home Assistant, create new switches with following lines. The number entered in the command and state topics is the number that you had assigned to the corresponding relay. So that's all for today. Hope this video will open up a lot new ways to deploy your Sonoffs into your home automation setup. For any query or suggestion, do comment below. If you like the content, consider subscribing this channel. So stay connected, stay safe, and we'll meet in another exciting video soon. Until then, goodbye.